I judge because you need to judge to be visible. Because if you're not visible and you don't know what's the latest on the dance floor, then you're has-been, you're past news. So you have to know what's current, because dancing changes, it evolves all the time. Like clothes, like shoes, like dresses, like trousers, it changes, so does dancing. So that's my avenue of learning what's current.
The trees hung low over their heads, the branches brushed their faces. No one said anything, they were lost.
I saw this person come towards me with white feathers and buku lipstick and eye makeup, and I say, who in the world is that? I know that person, but I don't. Then I looked the other way and I saw a black swan, but I recognized the profile of the black swan because he has a very distinct profile. And I said, that's Tibor. So I said, this one must be Peter Walker. Then they went on the floor and they got on their points. And I never thought a man could get on points. It was a light moment, a fun moment, a great moment. I thoroughly loved it, and I thought those two boys are very talented, and they did a great job. It was so entertaining.
I interviewed Pat for our magazine because I thought she is as American as apple pie, even though she was born in Persia. Like every one of us, she has really spent most of her life here in the United States and has given 100% of herself to the industry. And I thought it was very interesting, the amount of knowledge through the years that she has collected. I thought it was very important for everyone to know who she was, who she danced with, Terry Leone, the people that she met, what she thought about these incredible people that created our industry.
Well, the first time that I met Pat was at the Bill and Bobby Irvin Dance Studio in Streatham in London, and I think it was 1972. Bill and Bobby brought her into the studio. Myself and my former partner Carol were having a lesson at that time, so we were introduced to this very, very important person from the Arthur Murray organization, and that's how I first come to know Pat.
One time we danced at a metal ball, Chicago. Okay, and we were doing standard, I still laugh, waltz and tango. And Bill and Bobby Irvine, the world standard champions, were doing a show there. Okay? And they put us on right before they went on, doing international waltz and tango. And I kept saying to Pat, are you sure you want to do this? You want to go on right before them? Or do you want to go on at all?
I was 19 years old. Brand spanking new in the dance business, and she was conducting a training class for the teachers. And so it was tango. And so we're dancing, we're doing stuff, we're practicing, and I just hear, hey, pretty girl, do you make love with your eyes closed? So I'm like, oh, someone's getting yelled at. And I'm looking around to see, and I realized it was me.
She said, come over here. And I walked over, and she said, now don't say anything to me. And I'm like, she said, you're an absolute disgrace. I'm like, oh. obviously, I was taken aback a little bit. She said, I have been watching you now for a little while. Your dancing is fantastic. Your students are fantastic. They look fantastic, and you look a disgrace. I'm like, what have I done? She said, your armpits. I'm like, yeah, they're hairy. I'm like, oh, and what are they supposed to be? And she goes, you have to shave those. Your students, they spend thousands looking the way they do. They all dance great, and you are a disgrace. Shave your armpits. I now have two shaved armpits. And the up thing for the story, which I now hear that Pat tells people, is that if I go to a comp and I see somebody with hairy armpits, I totally agree with Pat. It looks absolutely awful. So, Pat, thank you very much.
The way she is, so immaculate dress and everything else, she expects the same from people who are professionals in our business. So she likes a good professional image.
She feels that there's a lock on our, on the glamour of the ballroom dance business, and has never, never not shown up looking absolutely glamorous. Every single minute of her day, I have never seen her look not absolutely pulled together.
It's a glamour business. You always, you have to look a certain way. She'd kill me right now because I don't have earrings on. So, you know, she'd be horrified right now because you always have to look, you have to look the parts. Be the part, look the part.
Pat is really straight up. You know, you got to be ready for it. There's many, many cases where I've seen people, you know, she doesn't like how they're dressed or they've got dirty shoes. She's right out there telling them, you know, what are you doing? You know, you need to wear clean shoes or what kind of dress is that? You know, you look like a 6-pound sausage in a 2-pound skin. She's not afraid to say exactly as it is. And, you know, we need people around like that because sometimes we go around the bushes and never actually directly say stuff. She's very direct about what she feels. But, you know, she always has your interest at heart. She wants you to be a better person or a better dancer, and she never does it from a position of trying to put you down.
I always had the sense of a very strong desire on Pat's part for me to do well and to do the best that I could. And I always thought that in her helping me out and coaching me in everything that she did, she really had, you know, sort of, she wanted me to win. She wanted me to do well at competitions, but she was also very concerned with me still being me. She wanted me to dance like Jay.
The thing that I really love about Pat with my students is that she understands that when she is doing a coaching session, that she has to get them to dance with me. So she will tailor what she says so that it's something that I am going to do with them. That's a really, really smart thing for a coach.
It's a historical record that she has of knowing the truth about good work and the validation of her saying, that is good work, almost brings a tear to my eye, for me personally.
She just also works. And for her to continue to do that is quite a big example for all of us.
My passion is to make people dance and be better. And when a teacher says, oh my God, this was so good, that's my biggest reward. That's the big medal that teacher pinned on me. Because a coach is human. They do it not just for the money. They do it to get to know that they achieved what they set out to do.
Congratulations, Pat. This is a wonderful night to be celebrating with you. You are so very much loved, and we are so completely blessed to have you in our lives.
Congratulations, Pat. I think you deserve everything that is being awarded to you and that is coming to you. You're a wonderful person, a special person, and I'm a better person for having known you, for having met you. Thank you.
Well, to my dear Pat, congratulations, and I have great privilege to have been associated with you for so many years. Congratulations again.
When I saw you at Tavern on the Green doing those champagne hours, I fell in love with you and Terry, and that brought Hollywood into my career. And here I am 51 years later, still knowing you, because I'm glad we're still alive. And I hope we're alive for a lot more to educate the youth into the dancing.
Pat, I wish I could be there. I am so happy that the people are honoring you tonight. It's great. Nobody deserves it more than you. You've been a great friend to me and to my children. And I love you very much. And I'm so glad that the whole world gets to see you honored like this.
Congratulations, Pat, on your award. You really deserve it. Enjoy it.
You continue to provide the inspiration and the love of a man and a woman holding each other, moving to the music across the floor. And with that inspiration constantly as you walk into a ballroom perfectly turned out every time I see you, I'm always reminded that you are full of grace and fill us full of your grace about what we do. Love you.
I feel really honored that you come to Super Shy. The most important thing, I feel really honored that I can count on you as a friend. So I hope you really enjoy tonight. Thank you, Pat.